हेलो, माई सेल्फ रेखा डामोर फ्रॉम परम गुरु पाठशाला इंग्लिश मीडियम स्कूल सहरसा। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट इकोनॉमिक्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 12th कॉमर्स। यूनिट नंबर 1, ग्राफ्स इन इकोनॉमिक्स। टॉपिक कवर aspects to be considered while drawing a diagram and graph and types of diagram and graph. Now we discuss about aspects to be considered while drawing a graph or diagram. Before we start our this topic, we have to know the meaning of diagram and graph. Diagram and graph have similar meaning. Diagram and graph means representation of observable data by way of pictures. Now we start our topic. First, choice of type of diagram or graph and their presentation. The right type of diagram or graph must be chosen to make a diagram or a graph more effective. For example, if a certain data can be presented in a divided bar diagram as well as in a pie diagram, then the right choice is necessary to make the diagram effective. If we get the information for which information both diagrams can be presented, means divided bar diagram and pie diagram, but we have to decide that which diagram is effectively present that information. So we have to choose the right diagram for the information. Second point is clarity. A diagram or a graph must look neat and clear. It is necessary to state that what presented data indicates. To make a diagram or a graph attractive, different shade must be used to denote the various components of diagram or graph. It means that the diagram which we want to draw is very clear and neat. And we have to use different colors and shades or pattern to denote the various components of diagram, so it is very easy to understand the diagram and the diagram is clearly show the difference between bars. Third point is scales and measures. To draw a diagram or a graph, scales must be selected in such a way that the diagram or graph look appropriate in size. It means we have to use scales and appropriate measurement to draw the diagram. Fourth point is representation of axis. It is necessary to state that what is presented on both axes of diagram or a graph. We know that in diagram, two axes are presented. First is x-axis and y-axis. So, independent variable is measured on x-axis and the dependent variable is measured on y-axis. Fifth point is sources of data. To make the diagram and graphs more reliable and authentic, they must be accompanied by the source of data. In our economics textbook, there are many diagrams are presented, but how can we realize that data are correct? So for that, in the data table, with data table, sources are given. So sources, one of the source of them is Census of India. If we see the source Census of India, we can understand that this data is authentic and true. So it is compulsory to mention the source of data with the diagram. Sixth point is method of calculating the data. When the data is not self-explanatory, it is simplified with statistical formula. So it is necessary to mention the statistical method briefly. Diagrams are for self-explanatory, but when we draw the graph or diagram for other people, it is necessary to mention the statistical method briefly, because he understands by which method and from which method we analyze that data. Next point is our types of diagram. There are many types of diagram commonly used, like pictogram. Pictogram is also known as pictograph. In this diagram, the data are presented by way of different symbols. For example, data on population would used by icon of people. Second, scatter diagram. Graph in which the values of two variables are plotted along two axes. Other four diagrams: line diagram, circle diagram, bar diagram, and pie diagram will discuss in this section in detail. Now we discuss about time-based line diagram. Time-based line diagram: slope curve of relationship between two variables. Pictures which shows the shape or slope of a relationship in economics between two variables are often drawn. For example, a demand curve, a supply curve, etc. Independent variable x-axis, dependent variable y-axis. The dependent variable is measured on x-axis and the dependent variable is measured on y-axis. Represent time-based self-explanatory trends of a variables. Economics often uses line diagram representing time-based self-explanatory trends of a variable. For example, size of population in different time periods, rate of inflation in various years, literacy rate in various years, etc. Such diagrams can be termed as time-based line curve. Now we analyze the time-based line diagram. For it, we take this example. If we want to know the percentage growth rate of India's population since 1951, we can see in the data table, in first column, decade are presented, and in the second column, decadal growth rate of population in percentage are presented. Now move on diagram. Years are presented on x-axis and growth rate of population presented on y-axis. In 1951 to 61, decadal growth rate of population is 21.64%. The combination of both presented by one point or dot. Like that, the combination of all decadal growth rate with their respective year are shown by various points. After joining these points, our diagram is complete. We find the slope or curve. We can find that the highest point in the diagram indicate the highest decadal growth rate of population, 24.80% in the decade 1961 to 71. The lowest point in the diagram indicate the lowest decadal growth rate of population, 17.64% in the year 2001 to 2011. We can see that it is easy to understand for person by way of diagram. Now we discuss the type of diagram, bar diagram, and types of bar diagram. Bar diagram shows distribution of the value of a variable in various components. For example, literacy rate in a country in various years, or literacy rate among females and males in a particular year. There are three types of bar diagrams. First, simple bar diagram. Second, clustered bar diagram. Third, divided bar diagram. Now, points for bar diagram. A vertical or horizontal bar. A vertical or horizontal bar is drawn for each value of the variable. Second, separate bar for each section or time period. A separate bar is drawn for each section or time period, and the height, length of the bar indicates the value for that section and time period. Thus, by comparison of height or length of the bars, a comparison can be made of the values of each section. Now, meaning an example of a simple bar diagram. Now, one of the type of bar diagram is simple bar diagram. We discuss about meaning and example of simple bar diagram. When the values of a variable for different places, times or things are given, the simple bar diagram is drawn. A simple bar diagram represents value of only one variable over a base, say various regions or years, etc. It gives visual effects of the difference in the value of the variable between regions, years, and so on. The analysis of diagram is important for your exam. Now, we analyze the simple bar diagram presented in this slide. Simple bar diagram. In the figure 1.1, the years of population census are shown on x-axis and population of the country in crore is shown on y-axis. In 1951, population of India was 36.1 crores, which rose to 102.7 crores after 5 decades, for example, in 2001. Thus, the registered growth in population was 66.6 crores. In present times, population of India increases by approximately 183 lakhs every year from 2001 to 2011. Next point is, India's population rose to 121.02 crores in 2011. Fifth, during the time interval 1951 to 2001, trend of population growth is seen continuously increasing. Now, we discuss the second type of bar diagram is clustered bar diagram. Clustered bar diagram is represent the value of a common variable over a common base are given for more than one section of related parameters. Hence, we get cluster of bars for the same. When the values of more than one variables are given for different places, times, or things, then clustered bar diagram is drawn. For example, if the data on literacy level of females and males for different time periods are given, then for one time period, two bars showing literacy level for females and males respectively are drawn in a cluster to create proper visual effect and for easy comparison. Each bar is colored differently. Now, we analyze our next diagram is cluster bar diagram. In this, age-wise population of India is given. In the figure 1.2, years of population are shown on x-axis and percentage of population is shown on y-axis. Second point is, in 2005, population in the age group 0 to 14 was 32.78%, which reduced to 30.5% in 2011. This shows a decrease in birth rate. Third point is, in 2005, population in the age group 15 to 64 was 62.44%, which increased to 64.3% in 2011. In this age group, majority of the population are working population. This shows economic development of our country. 4. In 2005, the population of people of age 65 and more was 4.78%, which rose to 5.2% in 2011, which is an indicator of increase in average life. Here we complete our today's topics. I hope you can understand it. Our next topic is that the type of diagram is divided by diagram. We discuss that point in our next video. So I complete my today's topic here. Thank you to all.